In this video, we're going to try to create a Node Express API with MongoDB and having the full sign up and login feature with hashing your password and using JWT. So let's get started. Let's go ahead and create a folder here so we can say Mictor, and we can call it like JWT Node Express API or something like that. Okay, and then we're gonna go inside of that JWT, and then once we're inside, let's go ahead and create a couple of files. So we can create an index.js file, a .git ignore file, and a .env file, and I think we're good for now. So that, and then we could do npm init -y, so you could just take all of the defaults. Okay, so this is how we create a normal API with Node. And then here we could also just install npm I, we need to install express course.env bcrypt json web token. And don't worry if you don't know what each of these things is, just go ahead and use them just to follow along. But really quickly, express is what we're going to use to create the API. Course is for any web application to be able to contact our Express API. .env, so we could store some secrets in the .env file. Bcrypt is the way we're gonna hash our passwords. JSON web token is how we're gonna create the JWT token. And MongoDB is how we're gonna interact with Mongo. So we hit enter on that. That shouldn't take long. Let's see. So go ahead and open up with code and VS Code. We're gonna start creating our API. So the first thing inside of the git ignore, we wanna add the node modules and the .env file. Okay, so the .env file is where we're gonna put secrets on there, okay? That we don't want it for it to reach GitHub, right? So we're gonna open up the terminal real quick. We're gonna close this thing out, and we could do git init so that git will start tracking all of our changes. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and close this for now. And let's start writing our API. So I kinda like to do better the type module so that we don't use the require. How we import packages, rather we're gonna use type module, so we gotta make sure that we change it here. The type, and then we just hit tab, and that module will come up there for us. Okay, cool. Now we should be able to use import express from express, import course from course, import bcrypt from bcrypt. We're also going to import JWT from JSON web token, and we could do also import .env /config so that we can start bringing in those secrets from the .env file. And then we could do import Mongo client like this from MongoDB. This is so that we can connect to Mongo and start adding data and all of this stuff. All right, so the first thing we could do is we could use this Mongo client. So Mongo client, okay, that takes in like some special URI, which I'll show you what it is in a little bit. But this is a constructor from Mongo. Okay, so I'm gonna create a new instance of this. So with const, just call it client. And like this, we're creating a new instance of Mongo, okay? So let's say this const, say URI. This is like a special URI that we get from Mongo, from MongoDB, okay? We're gonna connect via Atlas. If you don't know how to do that yet, it's okay, it's pretty simple, but once we have that link, we're gonna go ahead and put it in here, okay? And then, so we have the client. Now, after we have the clients, we should be able to call in this connect function. So we can connect, and then right now we just do a console log and say that I'm connected to Mongo, right? And that's just gonna tell us that it's connected to Mongo. Then once we have this client also, we could also connect into a DB, a database, and we could just reach into, let's say, a users database, okay? Remember Mongo, if it's not created, it's gonna go ahead and create it for you. So don't worry about it for now. I'm gonna create it for you. We're gonna just give it a name, database, so we can use it later. And then here, now with this database, we could get access to a collection where users, the database, let's just call the database like JWT API or something like that. And then the collection, we're gonna call it users. So the database has several collections. You could add several collections on here. So let's give this a name. So you can say like cons, user DB, users DB. There you go. Okay, so that now we can interact with our Mongo database. Okay. Let's use this express. So we get the express function from that express. Let's just call it app. We get from there, and then now that we have app, we want to use course, and we're also going to use express.json just to make sure that any post requests we'll be able to listen to those requests. So in here we're going to also just listen on port, let's say 4040, and we're going to have a call back here, just say console log API running, and let's give it some glasses with command. Oh, put it in the wrong place. You gotta go here. There we go. So with command control spacebar is how I was able to pull up that. And then like this, we should be able to actually just run it. So we could just say node dot. It's gonna go ahead and pick it up, my index.js, but it's better to have node mon so it can listen to my changes. So right now it's gonna crash because Mongo, I have this real weird URI for Mongo. So let's go ahead and fix that so we can start connecting to Mongo. So if you don't have a Mongo URI, you could definitely research that a little bit, but I'm gonna go ahead and put mine inside of here. I'm gonna just make it a little smaller because I don't want you guys to see it. I have my URI, but basically this is how we create a variable in a .env. Okay, you should use a string like this. And then I'm just going to paste it here, and that's my URI. And then once I paste it, I'm going to go ahead and use also a, let's say a port. Let's just give it a port of 4040. Oh, something's wrong. I better close it. There we go. Now port 4040. And we could save that. Now, since I've already added this environment variables into .env, now I could use this .env package, and I could go ahead and bring in inside of the URI. For example, here I could say process dot env dot mongo URI. There you go. And now I connected to Mongo and my API is running properly. Wonderful. So we're connected to it. We're connected to the Mongo instance, open Atlas, and our API is running. Cool. So let's create a couple of routes. So the first one, we're gonna create the sign up. Then we're gonna create the login. And then finally we're gonna create like get all users routes. Okay, so for the sign up, the first thing that we're gonna do is we're going to add a new user, right? We're gonna add a new user, and then we're going, before we add a new user, we need to get the user from the front end. Okay, then we're going to, maybe let's put it in steps. Then number two, we're gonna hash password. And then we're going to add the new user to MongoDB. Okay. So let's start with that. So the way that we start setting it up, we make it an app, make it a post. And I'm gonna just hide this guy a little bit here, get more real estate. Yep. So on the post, I could say the first thing is the route. So I could say just sign up, and then it takes a callback function. We're gonna make it like this, where we could go ahead and we could just create a new user object, okay, that we're gonna go ahead and start filling out, okay? But there's a couple of things in here that it takes. Okay, so the first thing is the request. The second thing is the response. Okay, so from the request, from the front end, it's gonna send us a request, and we're gonna grab that email from that request body, that email, and then we're gonna grab that password from the request body password. Okay, and that's coming from the front end, right? So now what do we do with this new user? Now with the new user, what we could do is we could now use this bcrypt library. I kind of skipped over the steps here, so let's bring it here. And so maybe there we go. So the new user, get the user from the front end, that's there. Now step number two, we're gonna hash that password that's coming from there. So we're gonna use this bcrypt library, and we're gonna hash, okay? And what are we gonna hash? Well, we're gonna hash the request dot body password, right? The password we're gonna get from the front end. Or better yet, we could just grab it from the new user. So we could just say like new user dot password, and that's how we get that password. And then we're gonna salt it. We can basically, it's a hashing algorithm. We can use random numbers. There's not random numbers, there's a list of numbers, but I tend to use the easiest one, which is 10. You can definitely Google that a little further about it. This bcrypt doesn't happen right away. We have to await it, okay? And every time you do any await inside of a function, you gotta make sure that you add async in front of the parameters, okay? So once this guy gives us a hash password, right, now we could add the user into Mongo. Okay, so now we could connect into Mongo and say like users DB, right, which is our collection users dot insert one. Okay, and what are we gonna insert? Well, we're gonna insert an object. We always insert an object in here. And the email is gonna come from the request body, that email. And I know we could do a lot of checking and making sure it has all the body and making sure that it's a post request and all that good stuff, but just to keep it short and straightforward, just keeping it simple here. And then we're going to also bring in the password. password, but now instead of just sending the password from the request body, you're gonna actually send the hash password, okay? Hash password, and like that. So now, that should all be working okay, but before we end it, we have to make sure that we send status back to requester, okay? And then, so we need to use this rest status, and we can say like 201, I think is the status of when something gets added to the database, and we can send user was added. Okay, so that's our post. Okay, now let's take a look to see if it works. Let's go into postman, and inside of postman, we're not gonna do a get request, we're actually gonna do a post, and then we're gonna type it here, HTTP, oh look at that, 4040, yeah, sign up is the path, right, for that route. And then on the body, you gotta make sure that we're gonna send raw data, that it's in JSON format, and then we're gonna send an email, and then email, you can just call it john at gmail.com, and then you could send the password, we could say pass 1234. All right, so we save that. Oh, actually, we have to save it. We could just send it. Okay, we send it, and it says user was added. User was added. Really? Well, let's take a look. Let's take a look at inside of our handy Mongo. Let me make a quick connection here. I have Compass in here. And Compass is gonna help us connect into our Mongo instance. And I'll show you in a little bit. Gotta paste this thing here. And this is what it looks like here. This is JWT API. Okay. We got users. And is that what we call the JWT API? Yep, JWT API. And look, John was added. I had an old user there, and just get rid of him. But this is the one added now. If you don't believe me, let's add one more. Let's add, instead of John, add Jane. Keep it all lowercase. Send. Refresh this guy. And now Jane is added there. Now look at the password. The password's hashed. Okay? So you don't see pass 1234. It's hashed with that algorithm of 10. Okay? Cool, so that's working. Let's set up the login. Just for interest of time here, I want to keep this video too long. So we say login, and then we have a callback function here. And right, just like this, we know that we're going to get a request and a response, and then we also make sure that we just make it async right away, because we know we're going to be dealing with some Mongo, and most likely it's going to be awaiting something, okay? So the first thing that we need to do here is we need to find the user, right? And then the second thing is we need to compare the password, password from request versus password in GB, right? Then on step three, then we're gonna create JWT token, okay? JWT token is basically like a passport, okay? So once the user has compared the password and it's all ready, it's good to go, we have authenticated. Okay, we have authenticated properly. Authentication is done. However, now authorization is where JWT takes place. So JWT is like your passport, right? When you go to a different country, it has your picture, your address. Well, I don't know if it has your address. I think so. I haven't seen the password in a while, but It has all your information, and you present your passport, and it has all the countries you visited and all your personal information, right? So that allows you to get to the country. So in this scenario, the JWT is your passport, where you're going to be able to present to the API and say, look, I have a JWT token, and if it's valid, go ahead and come in. If it's not valid, then don't come in. So let's start with this one here. So what we could do is, let me get my notes back up here. Yep, nice. Okay. So right on the suppose request. So what we could do is, we could have this user's DB, and then we could find one. Okay. And we're gonna find it as an object. We're gonna find it via email. Okay. We're gonna grab that request body, and we're gonna grab that email that's coming from the request, right, from the front end. We have to await that, right? And then once we await that, let's give it a name of just very creative user, right? And then once we have the user, we could start seeing the password that the user sent. So we could use this bcrypt library again, and we could now compare. Okay, we want to compare what? We want to compare the passport that's coming from in the body password versus the password that the user has stored in the database. Okay, so once we find this user, okay, we're gonna call it user, and then the user is gonna have a bunch of stuff inside. One of them is the password, right? Which is this guy here. We saw it, the password. Okay. Then in here, we're gonna compare it with whatever's coming in. Okay. We also have to await that. Okay. Once we await that, what we need to do now is we can give it a name. We can just say like, okay, const user allowed. Okay. So we have user allowed, and then once the user is allowed, okay, so we can say like if user is allowed, so basically the passwords are matched. So user allowed or authenticated, you call it whatever you want. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a JWT token, okay? So we're gonna create a sign. Okay, we're gonna create this JWT token that has all these user information. What are we gonna put inside? What are we gonna put inside of that JWT? So what we're gonna put inside is we're gonna put the entire user that we found. Okay, we found the user, then put the entire user on there, and then we have to tell it like a secret key. So we could call it, I don't know, we could call it just secret key don't tell anybody, right? It could be a string, it could be whatever you want, right? Then what that's gonna give us, it's gonna give us an access token, okay? And then that access token, we could send it to the front end, okay? So you can send it to the front end. Authentication. Yeah, I think I spelled that right. Yeah, okay. So you say rest, let's send, and then we can say access token, and then we just send that access token back to the front end. We can say status, I think maybe 200, I think. But quoting that, you could definitely Google those messages. Else, rest send, say no user found or invalid password, right? You don't want to tell the front end exactly what went wrong, because they're gonna keep trying, right? Cool. So like this, we're finding the user, then we're comparing the password, we're making sure that the passwords match. If they do, then we're gonna create a JWT token that we're gonna send to the front end. So maybe this should be like step 4. Send JWT token to front end. requested. Okay, cool. So let's see if that works. Let's go back over here. Rather than sign up, we're gonna do a login, and we should be able to send all these things here. So we're gonna see if Jane is gonna be authenticated. So we post, so hit send, bam. Now we get an access token, okay? This is the access token that was created here, okay? That's the whole access token, nice. So now the front end has this access token, which now you can save to your local storage and your React or Vue or any web app, right? But what's interesting about the access token now is that we could create a new route to get all users, for example. So we could get, in this one, you could just leave it like that if you want. And then we know we can do async. And we know that it's going to have a callback, and here we know it's going to be a request and a response. And then here, what the steps will be to get token from request body, which is from request. Then step number two is verify token with the secret key, right? The secret key. And once we do that, then we could allow user to get all users from MongoDB. Okay. So that's the idea, and yeah, that's the main idea. So let's do that. So the first thing is we need to go into the request, and then we're gonna look at the headers. Okay, inside of headers, there's authorization. Okay, and then once we get that, let's give it a name. Let's just call it token. So it's const token. And let's just see what that comes with. Also log token. Let's see what that comes with real quick. And let's just see what. So this is to get all users. So it's gonna go like this. Post. I'm going to do a get. Hit send like this. And then look, right now we're getting undefined, right? Because we're not sending any authorization in the headers. Okay. So what we need to do is, inside of headers, we could do it manually, but why do it manually? Let's go to authorization, let's go to bear, what's it called? Okay, bearer token, there we go. And the bearer token, okay, we're gonna grab this token that was sent to us from the front end. Once we logged in, we're gonna send this bearer token, okay? And then we're gonna send it in, and now look what we get. We get bearer, and then we get the whole token. Okay, we don't need this word bearer. What we need is the token. So we need to do some string manipulation here a little bit, where we could just say like Rick, headers, authorization. And there's many ways to do this, but we're just gonna do a split on here, and we're gonna just remove that space that we have in there, and we're gonna grab the second item on that array. Okay, so we're gonna send it again so you can see what's happening. Now we're only getting that clean token without the bearer phrase in front of it, okay? Cool, so now once we get the token, we know that it's working. The second thing is we need to verify the token. So what we could do is use that JWT, and then we could verify that token, okay? And what are we gonna verify? Well, we're gonna verify that token against I'm gonna verify the token against our secret key, right? This is our secret key, very, very secret. Keep it, you know, hush, hush. And then here, the third parameter that it takes is a callback function that call it decoded, and this is a callback function here. The third parameter where we could just say console log. And so we can say decoded. So we can see what has been decoded. Okay, so if I send this user with this bearer token, I'm gonna see what is inside of that JWT token. So I'm gonna hit send, and when I hit send, look, check it out. My decoded message, look, brings in the entire user. Okay, it has the email, the ID, the password, and all that good stuff. So in here, we have basically opened up their passport and be able to see all of their information, okay? We're not able to see it just with the token. We have to send it to the API uses the secret key and opens that passport, okay? So now we have the passport, nice. So now what we could do, if it's decoded, so we could just say here, like, if decoded, then we could say, users DB find, we want to send all the users to array, and basically we're doing step number three here. So we can say do like that and say allow users to get all users from one of these. Okay, and then we're gonna have to await that, and if we await something, remember we gotta add the async in front, returns a promise, and then we're gonna give this name of const, all users, and then here we're going to do a res status, let's say 200, then send all users, okay? So if the user was decoded, meaning the JWT token is valid, we were able to decode that user, then we're gonna send all users to that, to back to the requester. Else, otherwise we get an error, then we can just say res, that is, let's say 401, .send, and then we could just say, you can just JSON it like this, just say error, you must have a valid token. Okay, awesome. So let's see now, let's see if that works. We're gonna go ahead and hit send. Bam, our API has decoded that JWT token, and then it's now allowing me to see all the users. Okay, now if I break this authorization token, for example, I hit send, bam, it gives me, hey, you must have a valid token, okay? So I hope that helped. I wanna keep this as short as possible, so make sure that the .env doesn't go into your Git repo, right? Because otherwise Mongo is gonna just cancel it. I hope this helped you guys, and I hope that explains a little bit of how that all works. And if you have any questions, definitely just post them below, and I hope you see you in the next time. See ya.